Ready for bed, honey?
Not yet. I've got a few more pages left.
Don't be long. What?
The chair moved by itself. It went back and then it went forward again.
Come to bed.
Chair moved, Vernon. Let's leave this place, Vernon.
Don't let your imagination run away with you.
It's not my imagination. I saw it. Oh, Vernon, let's leave, please. There's something living here.
I paid for a week, and I'm going to stay for a week. You can leave if you want to.
Find out anything else about Meena?
Not much.
Meena's alive in that house. I've seen her and I've heard her crying. And last night, a chair moved.
Are you sure it wasn't the wind?
The wind can't move a chair.
Well, it must be Meena.
It was a supernatural force. I felt the presence.
Yeah.
is the matter?
I just saw her.
Meena?
Yes.
What are you doing?
Well, this is the only thing in this room. Answer must be in here. Must be in here.
Closer.
We need your help.
I am old now, not as strong as I used to be.
I am Vernon Kent. This is my wife. For sure, this is Molly, a friend.
What can I do for you?
We're staying at the Mercer place. We have seen and heard some strange things.
What kind of things?
A woman.
I've seen her and I heard her crying.
Meena. I've heard about her.
But she's dead, isn't she?
Yes, she's dead.
But if she's dead, how can she exist?
The matter that this man, the body, dies and is eaten by worms or time, but the soul, the real man, lives on forever. But there are occasions when the soul refuses to leave the earth for one reason and another, usually after an accident or a sudden death, and is seen either in some place of that place of the accident or some familiar place where he dies. And he tries to communicate with the living.
What can be done?
The soul must be put to rest.
Can you do it for Meena?
I don't know. I fought these demons a long time, but I was younger then. Sometimes they fight hard.
But you can't let her wander around like that.
I must meditate and pray before I decide.
I wonder if he can do it.
About the property Dad gave us,
Patricia, I already told you I have no intention of taking anything from your father.
Whether or not you like it, it's in our names. Oh, come on, Vernon, be sensible about it.
Let's talk about something else.
Why don't you come and work for Dad? You can make a lot more money than if you work for yourself. And it would be like working for yourself anyway. Mom left all her shares in the company for me, and what's mine is yours.
I can't take anything from you, Trish.
I know you said so often enough, but I want to share it with you. Oh, Vernon, it's not you, it's not me, it's us. Forget about what people say and just concentrate on us. Here comes your hunter.
I thought I'd find you here when I didn't see any enemy. I've been doing some checking, so I brought you here. I found out that it's exactly 1 year ago that Meena was killed. Tonight is the first anniversary of her death, and I do not think that you two should stay in that house.
Look, look, I've never run from anything in my life, and I don't intend to start now. Thanks for your advice.
If Vernon is staying, I'm staying too.
I just wanted to warn you.
Come to put Meena to rest.
I'm calling on you to leave this place.
Is she?
Yes.
Well, that's the end of Meena.
I wonder.
You wake me.
Didn't have the heart to. I knew you wanted your beauty sleep. Now that this Meena thing is over, why don't we relax and enjoy your honeymoon?
I have to make breakfast first.
Forget breakfast. We'll have an early lunch.
I've been thinking about that property your father bought for us. And I don't want you to feel you're making a sacrifice by marrying me.
So we move in?
Yes. We move in. But that's the only allowance I'm making. Just let your father know that, okay?
Sure.
Don't be too long now. To us.
To us. Is that Meena again?
No, I'm sure it isn't. Let me check. Just the window that was open. What's the matter?
I don't know. I suddenly feel so faint.
You know what I think?
What?
I think you're pregnant.
Oh.
She won't be awake for a couple hours yet.
Good.
Now, all we have to do is put her in the car, crash it, set fire to it. I collect the insurance, all her shares in her father's business, and the $1 million property in Goodwood Park. We are set for life, and Fahey won't have to bother about a thing.
You're a genius, you know, Vernon.
Not really. It's just that I planned it right. Trisha. It would have been painless.
But you loved me, Vernon.
Brendan,
how could you?
Brendan, I planned this over a year ago. I had to make sure I was your beneficiary.
My father will suspect something.
I have it all planned, completely worked out. You were driving to the village to get some groceries when the car leapt off a cliff. It caught fire. Your body will be burnt. I, of course, will be heartbroken. I won't eat or sleep for a month. Then send me to a rest home where I'll stay for a couple months. Brenda will come to see me, of course. After a year, we'll get married, Brenda and I.
How could you? I thought you loved me.
You're spoilt, Trisha. You're spoilt, rotten. Let's go to the car.
No! No! No!
Let her go. She's my wife. She's sick. I said to her, let her go. Can you drive?
I think so.
Go to the police. Tell them everything. Look. I'll give you anything you want. Just let me go. There's some people who can't buy, boy. She was supposed to be asleep for hours. It was Meena. Who the hell is Meena? She was my daughter. I hope she finds peace now.
Staring through the night, in her heart there now prevails a restlessness like those in fairy tales. Crying, weeping voices in the night, a mystery though not untold, still unexplained to me in all the world. Fell in love, that's all.